coming up on Marriage Today with Jimmy and Karen.
I can look in somebody's face and just say, okay, there's something about them and I want to figure it out, or, you know, I want to get to know them more. I want to know what's triggering their thinking, because it's like you can see in somebody's eyes how they think and how they feel. And so it's like, you know, okay, something's going on. I want to know what it is.
The Strengths Finders has helped me so much to understand that about her and not to judge it the way I once did as being nosy or as being wrong. But to understand it's a strength. And she brings that strength into our marriage. Welcome to Marriage Today. I'm Jimmy Evans. I want to welcome you to a very special program because we're talking about our differences and making our differences dynamic rather than being dangerous. In many marriages, you know, we're different by God's design. You're just not going to marry a person just like you. If you marry a normal man, a normal woman, they're just different. You want to be compatible, and that means that you share the same values and character and beliefs in God and things like that. So compatibility is important. But even when you're compatible, you're still very different. And early in our marriage, Karen and I, we just simply did not understand that we were different by God's design. I thought Karen was the most beautiful woman I'd ever seen and the weirdest woman I'd ever seen. And I told her that. I rejected her. I shamed her. She rejected me. And we fought like cats and dogs because we simply didn't understand. We both had strengths that we brought into the relationship and that they were different. Karen's number one strength in marriage is my number 34. We're talking about a strengths-based marriage. There are 34 strengths possible. We don't have 34 strengths, but there's 34 possible. And what that means is you marry someone very different than you. God wired you that way to marry someone different than you. And it means they have different strengths. And when you bring your strengths together, it makes a strong marriage. But when you reject each other and judge each other the way that we did early in our marriage, it makes a very dangerous scenario. So we want to talk to you in this program today about how you can understand your strengths, how you can share your strengths in marriage and respect those and have the marriage of your dreams. Today I want to share with you an incredible revelation that I wish we had years ago. Karen and I recently completed our Clifton StrengthFinder assessment with strength coach Alan Kelsey, and here's what we discovered.
I think that your number one empathy as the top strength and the way that you look at life is, it's envious for me because for me it's super low, and so I don't understand it. I don't understand how you see the world this way. But what it typically means is that you intuitively understand the emotions of other people. Do you feel that way?
Oh, yes. In fact, Jimmy likes to say that I'm kind of nosy because I can see things and talk about people and look at something, and he's like, Karen, just none of your business. Just be quiet.
It made me nervous for so many years because that's what I thought is just stay out of their business.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But she does know.
So you're picking up on things that we can't even see.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And I can look in somebody's face and just say, okay, there's something about them and I want to figure it out, or, you know, I want to get to know them more. I want to know what's triggering their thinking, because it's like you can see in somebody's eyes how they think and how they feel. And so it's like, you know, okay, something's going on. I want to know what it is.
Yeah.
It's a detective mind.
So she said something interesting. She said, you can see in somebody's eyes. Can you see in somebody's eyes?
Absolutely not. And I don't care.
I can't see it either. So see how easy it is to kind of overlook this natural ability that you have?
It's so easy to do. The Strengths Finders has helped me so much to understand that about her and not to judge it the way I once did as being nosy or as being wrong.
Yeah.
But to understand it's a strength.
Yeah.
And she brings that strength into our marriage.
So your number two is developer. And so what this means, just in a short abbreviated version, I don't want to try to put you in a box, but I'm just trying to get you started here, is that you see the incremental improvements in people or in things as they're getting better. And it has this draw, like it draws you in where you want to be involved in helping develop people and get them moving. Have you seen that as a part of your life in the way you've lived it in the past?
Oh, yeah. I mean, I can think of, you know, if I today, I think about the grandkids. You know, and I see the kids, you know, as they're growing and I'm interacting with them and I'm like, you know, I can see the potential of where they were before and where they are now. And it's just like, I want to get in there and I want to help. But then I have to be careful because I'm the mother-in-law too. And I can't be too pushy and I can't, you know, exert my, you know, opinion or what I think sometimes. So there's a balance, you know, of what you can see in somebody else, but respecting other people, you know, as you make that progress.
Karen's a great discipler. She, through the years, I don't know how many people Karen has discipled. And she'll take a person under her wing and someone that really needs a lot of help, someone a lot of times who's pretty rough, many times are new believers, and sometimes they're not even believers. And Karen will just very patiently pull them along one step at a time. Mm. It really, she's very, very gifted at that.
So your number three strength is restorative. And the essence behind restorative is that you see a former glory in an object or in a person, and your desire is to get them back to this beautiful state. Mm-hmm. Can you think of an example where that was really real for you in your past?
Probably what was real for me is I used to be like that. You know, I can remember how yucky I was in the past. I didn't like the way I looked, how I felt. I remember just that pain of not liking yourself, you know, that self-hate. And, you know, and seeing now what God's done, it's like, I want to help somebody else see what God can do. You know, that you don't have to live like that. You can be something else. You know, you can be what God wants you to be.
Certainly, certainly. Mm-hmm. Okay, so it's followed up by responsibility. And people with responsibility are just utterly dependable, salt of the earth kinds of folks. If we ask you to do something, you are going to follow through with it just about no matter what. And it makes our lives so much more restful because we know you're going to get that thing done. Tell me about a time when that's been true for you. Or maybe you should answer that for her, Jimmy.
Well, that's true, Karen. She's just ultra responsible. You know, the day before, she's getting ready for the next day and everything that she's responsible for. And it's great. I mean, she's just, you know, steady Eddie, and she's very, very, if Karen's going to take care of it, she's going to take care of it.
Yeah. So the final strength then is harmony. And harmony is interesting because typically it presents itself as saying, I just like everybody to get along. I want there to be cohesion. I want people to be happy together. And you will do what's necessary to accommodate that so that the environment looks and feels that way. Mm-hmm. Is that just with people, or will you change things in your home for there to be harmony?
Yeah, I mean, I'm more the person that stands off to the side and is busy doing things while everybody else is socializing, you know, like the family's around. Mm. And as I'm watching things happening, I'm like off to the side, but at the same time, I'll interject. And, you know, I'll hear a conversation going on and Jimmy will be saying something. I'm thinking, I need to interject so that it keeps peace.
Ah.
You know, so it's like I can, and I know sometimes he gets frustrated with that because I think he thinks I'm undermining what he's thinking or saying. But at the same time, I'm looking at the whole group and I'm watching the countenances of everybody or the responses of everybody. And so I'm thinking, I need to say something so-and-so doesn't feel like, you know, they're not a part or, so I can kind of do that.
How do you interpret that when she's doing that, Jimmy?
It helps to understand it. it does, because that's the way I did interpret it for a long time, is why can't she just let me say something and leave it alone?
Ah.
You know, why does she always have to interject?
Okay.
But she is trying to bring harmony, and she's really good at that. And I'm not as sensitive, so I can be saying some things that could be interpreted as insensitive or exclusive to a person standing up here. And Karen picks up on that. And it goes back to the issue of we're a good team.
Yeah.
And so knowing that she has that strength, and that's why she's saying that, it helps me a lot.
Well, so if I look at all of your strengths and kind of bundle them together, it looks like the leading, strongest parts of who you are have this orientation toward people and interacting with people. And so you're a little bit less interested in stuff or things and much more interested in people and how they relate and the emotions attached to them. Mm-hmm. That's where your superpowers rest. Yes, I understand that. This list of strengths that we have, there's 34 of them on there. And they range from the ones that are strongest in the upper register to the ones that have the least influence or power in your life toward the bottom of the list. And what's so fascinating about the pair of you is, honestly, if you guys had come to me for some marriage counseling before you got married, I would have had to take a long pause before I would say, I think it's a good idea that you get married. Because really, you're about as opposite as you could get. I mean, really, what's interesting to you or what you find motivating as an individual? Jimmy, I mean, Karen's, that's the least interesting thing to you, Karen. So how does that work in your marriage? I mean, if you're finding something attractive in him, but what he's great at is really not interesting to you at all.
Well, I think it goes back to our hearts. You know, that even though we were so opposite, I could see into his heart. And I could see past the achiever.
Yeah.
And I could see that there really was somebody in there I could connect with. And because I do have that empathy thing, I figured out a way to get to him apart from his achieving abilities.
I see.
And so we developed that really close relationship as friends.
Yeah.
And yes, of course, you know, as time went on, the first 5 years, those two dynamics were volatile. I mean, you know, we had huge fights all the time because, you know, he would accuse me of being mothering and, you know, trying to baby him. I'm like, no, I'm just trying to be your friend. And I'm just kind of trying to sympathize with what's going on. And he would always see that as, don't tell me what to do, you know, or, you know, and so there's just this dynamic of his strength of character. But at the same time, because I was so shy, I think if I had been a confident woman at the time, it would have been worse.
Mm.
But because I was so shy, it was easy for me to back down
and
you know, kind of go back inward and kind of let him do his thing and be dominant.
So as an achiever, you love to get things done. Yeah. When you're interacting with her, she's displaying this unintentional perspective that says, I'm kind of not interested in getting a lot of stuff done. When you saw that, did that rub you wrong, or how did you deal with that difference?
Well, early in our marriage, I shamed it. I mean, I rejected it,
and I
would just shame her. And it was like, you're just kind of like a deadbeat. You know, you just want to feel and talk and, you know, and I want to change the world and get all this stuff done. But I'm thankful for it because she keeps me normal. Because without her, I would do too much. I would not be domestically centered. My heart would not have been turned toward my children.
Yeah.
You know, I would have been one of those guys that just went out and built a big company and made money and brought it home to a miserable family. Mm. But Karen tethered me emotionally to the home. And when we first got married, I mean, we both rejected each other. We both thought the other person was damaged. But today we see, and this is what I love about the book that we wrote, Alan, and about helping people understand their strengths. It's a strength.
Yes.
Her empathy and her developer and all these other things, these are strengths that she brings to our home. People say to Karen and me all the time that they're just kind of surprised that, you know, how we talk about our marriage and how we're so transparent. But we love it. We really do, because it helps other people. And as you could hear as a part of that interview with Alan Kelsey, who's the strength expert, you know, we're very, very different people by God's design. And there was a time that we rejected each other, didn't understand each other, but it's just so wonderful to live in a marriage where we know we're different, we celebrate that, but to understand not just our differences, but our different strengths. That's what makes a strong marriage. We want you to have these resources that are a part of the strength-based marriage resource that we have, and we want to begin with your gift of any amount with a teaching that I do. It's called The Healing Journey of Marriage. We want to give you the CD single or the MP3 download for your gift of any amount right now to help us at Marriage Today to take this message back to you, but across America, around the world, helping couples thrive in marriage and keeping families together, keeping little children together with their parents. When you help us here at Marriage Today, we want to bless you, but that's what you're helping us to do, is to help people in marriage. For your gift of $55 or more, we want to send you the book. Alan and I wrote the book, Strength-Based Marriage, that this whole resource, these programs are a part of. We're going to send you the book. The book has 2 hours of resource footage that's a part of it, video footage. Plus, we're going to send you the CD series, 4-part CD series, Lifelong Love Affair. It's a seminar that I do, really give you some tremendous information on how to have a lifelong love affair with your spouse the way God designed. For your gift of $90 or more, we're going to send you the Strength-Based Marriage book with the video series of Lifelong Love Affair, 4-part series. We want to bless you. We want to help you in your marriage. And, you know, as you're listening to me right now, you may be thinking, you know something, I've got a friend that's struggling, or a family member, or a child getting married, or something like that, and these would really be a blessing to them. Absolutely. It might be that you would use it for yourself to encourage yourself in marriage, but it also might be that you want to get these for somebody else. We want you to support us here at Marriage Today, and we want to be a blessing to you in return. Here's how you can get these life-changing resources.
Discover you and your spouse's unique strengths and how they affect every part of your relationship. Strengths-Based Marriage, a new book from Jimmy Evans and Gallup-certified strengths coach Alan Kelsey, takes the concepts from the popular Clifton StrengthsFinder assessment and applies them to marriage.
There are 34 strengths that describe the way that you are motivated to behave in any given situation.
Understanding your strengths and how they relate to marriage is life-changing.
Support marriage today with your best online gift of any amount, and we'll send you The Healing Journey of Marriage. Get the book Strengths-Based Marriage for your gift of $55 or more. Over 2 hours of video footage from the authors is included with the book purchase. We'll also include Jimmy's popular CD series, Lifelong Love Affair. For your gift of $90 or more, you'll receive the Strengths-Based Marriage book with video footage, plus the entire Lifelong Love Affair series on DVD. Build a stronger relationship by understanding each other's gifts. Get your copy today.
Hello, I am Alan Kelsey, strengths coach and co-author of the book Strengths-Based Marriage. Now, earlier in the program, Jimmy and Karen shared that their strengths are not only different, they are nearly exact opposites of one another. It's no wonder their marriage was such a struggle in the early years. Just like Jimmy and Karen, it's important to realize that your spouse literally sees the world through a different set of strengths than you do. Now, this influences their actions and every area of their lives. Your differences don't have to divide you. Your differences can actually bring you closer together. Now, we're going to hear from some other couples who've experienced their own dynamic differences and how they've learned to overcome. Here are your strengths. Sean, there's yours on the left side. Lynette, yours on the right there. And although there's some similarity in colors, there's quite a bit of difference in the way that you guys see life. So, Sean, you've got learner, belief, focus, individualization, futuristic. Lynette, you've got belief also, but you lead with restorative. Context, ideation, connectedness, they're fairly different. When I think about your interest in context, right? Just your ability to look back, the value that you place on knowing how we got to this place. But you're married to a guy who has futuristic, right? Mm-hmm. Whose windshield is so much bigger than his rearview mirror. It's almost like he doesn't care to look in the rearview mirror. All of the problems can be solved out in tomorrow. All of the solutions are waiting for us in the future. And so that to me feels like it might create a place for misunderstanding at the very least. So would you share a little bit about what that dynamic looks like either at home or at work for the two of you guys?
We're always explaining our motives.
Okay.
Or we're always having to explain ourselves.
Yeah.
Assumptions are really, really bad with us because we are so different.
Yeah.
That if you don't get a clear understanding as to where I was coming from, you can really take my motives and just really take them the wrong way.
Right.
So we're really always having to explain, you know, the perspective or what I was thinking when I was saying this.
Mm. Does that work, the explaining?
It does.
Yeah.
It's a necessity. I want to make sure that home base is taken care of really well and that we're going to have a great future. Mm. So I'm always thinking forward. And for her, she's kind of making sure that we've reconciled the past. So it's a really good thing. But for me, sometimes it may feel like it's dragging me backwards. It's slowing us down from getting to a specific destination. Whereas not everything is great in the past. So
let's leave it there.
So let's just leave it and move on.
Right.
And so I think it's a great balance when we are on the same page.
Yeah.
Because she gets to say, hey, remember this time, or don't forget in our processing and going forward at, you know, super speed, we can do it in a way that we don't leave our family behind or make mistakes that'll cost us in the long run.
Yeah. I want to introduce you to two of my great friends, Tara and Rob. Tara and Rob, thanks so much for joining us today. I wanted to get straight into your strengths, and why don't we take a look at them? They're right up here on the board. Tara, you have, wow, look at that. 80% of your strengths are relationship-building strengths. Wow, you have such great power in that area. So you go developer, empathy, positivity, relator, and then maximizer at the end there. That's fantastic. Rob, you've got 60% of your strength is in this kind of accomplishing, executing category. And so you start out with responsibility. You have activator, belief, relator, and achiever. Seems like relator is the only one that you share, and that both of you have it at number four. So knowing that he's wired that way, do you interpret that the way he feels about it? Do you see that as restlessness? How do you interpret his need to move and do? And
I would say that probably is one of the, an issue at times in our relationship.
Sure.
Because I feel like because he's so task-oriented and I need to achieve, that a lot of times, like even when we're spending time together, and I'm very relational, so like quality time is something that I really desire and need. And it almost feels like he's like, okay, this is part of the checklist. Let's get this quality time over with so it can be achieved.
Yes.
You know, that's how it feels. And I know he can say that that's not his heart, but that's how I perceive it sometimes because he is wired that way. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Well, the language that in this regard that I have found helpful is that for a person built like Rob is, an achiever, someone who finds a sense of completion over something being done.
Yes.
If there was a way for you to be able to say, I will be good when we get to this point, then he'll know when we get there and he'll be able to check his box and you'll feel like, okay, I got my box checked also. Although you're not as interested in the box checking thing as he is.
Right. He literally asks me that all the time. Are we connecting right now? Mm. Yes.
Did we connect? Did I do a good job connecting? Do you feel like we've connected? Because I need that, hey, you achieved that.
Yeah.
Does that take some of the specialness of the moment out of it for you?
Yes, definitely.
Why?
Because it's like, how do you not understand and know that we just connected and you literally have to ask me if we connected?
Yeah.
Don't you feel connected?
Mm.
No.
No.
He has to be told.
That's right.
Well, I hope you've enjoyed this program today. And the purpose of this program and this series of programs that we're doing on strengths-based marriage is to help you to understand that you can have the marriage of your dreams, but you need to understand each other. What I love about the Clifton Strength Finder, the 34 strengths that Alan has been talking about in the interview today, you know, you see how Karen and I have such different strengths. But we make a great team. Early in marriage, we didn't understand that. We fought like cats and dogs. We rejected each other. We shamed each other. And for us, marriage was not a healing journey the way that God intended. It was a very damaging journey. We were damaging each other because we rejected each other. Today, we're very, very different people. But it's so wonderful when something happens, when Karen does something or I do something, rather than seeing that as a weakness and judging it and rejecting it, I look at Karen doing something and I realize that's her strength. She's very different than me. And thank God in the areas that I'm weak, she's strong. And yeah, we share some things in common. That's a good thing. But there are many areas of our lives that are very different. And we now understand that. And we can live in a happy, strong marriage. And that's what we want for you. That's why Alan and I wrote the book, Strengths-Based Marriage. That's why we're doing this series of programs, is to help you to come to an understanding, a better understanding, that God made marriage in such a way that he brings two beautiful, wonderful, unique people together in a marriage where we share our strengths together. And that we make each other stronger because of the complementary nature of our lives being shared together. And I hope that this has been a blessing to you. And I hope in just a minute, we're going to remind you about the resource offer today. I hope that you'll make yourself available to some of the resources because they really will bless you. And so thank you for being a part of the program today. If you're not a partner with us here at Marriage Today, please consider becoming a partner. We have different levels of partnership. But when you become a partner with Marriage Today, you're helping us go across America, around the world, helping people thrive in marriage, keeping little children together with their parents, and helping a new generation to understand marriage and not to be victims, but to be victors. in the area of their marriages. Thank you for joining us today. Here's how you can become a partner with us.
We all enter into marriage confident a happy, fulfilling life is in front of us. Over time, life's journeys can quickly deflate those expectations, and we're left feeling like we've fallen out of love. But with the right information and a mutual commitment to success, a better marriage is possible. Become a rock-solid partner and gain instant access to practical marriage help in topics ranging from communication, needs, and intimacy, as well as blended families, intentional dating, spiritual health, and much more. Marriage Today exists to help every person succeed in marriage. With your help, we can continue raising a standard for marriage and reverse the curse of family breakup in order to rebuild the nations one home at a time.
That's why we're tied into the ministry. We want to be able to bless and give so they can keep doing what they're doing.
There's just millions of marriages that need help. And if this is a way we can help facilitate that, then that's a great way to spend some money.
We love Jimmy and Karen, and we love learning more about how to be a better couple and how to help other couples like they do.
Become a rock-solid partner with the ministry and mission of Marriage Today. Thank you for watching Marriage Today with Jimmy and Karen. Subscribe to Marriage Today's YouTube channel for more marriage-building videos and updates.